Get your backpack ready. It's time to brainstorm another trip. This week, in our whirlwind tour of the history of science, let's travel to the Italian Renaissance, the 1400s, or Quattrocento, the 15th century. I hope you'll make some meaningful and unexpected discoveries this week as we explore the strange new world of the era of Michelangelo and Raphael, the century of Leonardo da Vinci, of humanism, Neoplatonism, the Hermetic tradition, and the printing press. Though we have just a limited time to visit, we'll not be like tourists in Florence who seek fast food at McDonald's. Our aim will be to get to know the 15th century scientists in terms of their own place and time, not just in terms of modern science. Renaissance literally means rebirth, and the Renaissance was the name Italian writers gave to the Quattrocento, or 1400s, the 15th century. 2 weeks ago, we explored why modern historians speak of a 12th century Renaissance, but these Italian writers wanted a name that would distinguish themselves from previous centuries, and to assert that in them, the glory and grandeur of ancient Rome was reborn. Thus, they referred to the previous centuries as the Middle Ages, dividing Rome from themselves. After the devastations of the plague brought the 14th century to a close, the 15th century confidence and optimism seemed welcome, and so the terms Middle Ages and Renaissance became widely adopted. What most interests you about the 15th century as a context for science? Have you seen Brunelleschi's dome in Florence? Brunelleschi's dome became a symbol of the rebirth and of the ascendancy of Florence in the Italian Renaissance. Filippo Brunelleschi won a public competition in 1418 to complete the ambitious project, and he worked on it for most of the rest of his life. What do you appreciate most about 15th century art? Michelangelo painted the Sistine Chapel ceiling and sculpted the Statue of David in Florence. In Rome, Raphael painted the School of Athens in the Vatican and was an architect for St. Peter's Basilica. Botticelli painted the Birth of Venus. What most interests you about 15th century culture? Have you visited Italy, Florence, or the Renaissance-era districts of European cities? Do you speak or read Italian? What do you most appreciate about 15th century literature? Have you read Petrarch, Boccaccio, or other Renaissance literature? What is your favorite movie related to 15th century Europe? As always, when we're planning a trip, we want to better understand what people in this place and time were up to. So what were some similarities between 15th century culture and our culture today? How might these similarities help us to understand 15th century science? And what are some differences between the Renaissance and our culture today? How might these differences pose an obstacle for our understanding of 15th century science? What do you think might be the chief barrier or prejudice that obstructs modern appreciation of science in the Renaissance? Who is your favorite Renaissance scientist? Please share your thoughts on these things. What are your starting assumptions?